Welcome to Elhoff Academy. Today we are going to see together the introduction to human anatomy and physiology. Are you ready? Wow, let's go started. By using the book of Anatomy and Physiology authored by Kenneth L. Saladin in Georgia College and State University, anatomy is defined as study of structure, and physiology is defined as study of function. Let's start by human anatomy. Human anatomy studies the structure of human body, the levels of organization of human body. Have you ever had time to think about the organization of human body structure? Well, the level of organization of human being as an organism from the smallest to largest are molecule, cell, tissue, organ, organ system, population, community, ecosystem, and biosphere. Remember that cytology is the branch of biology which studies on cell. In addition, histology is branch of biology which studies tissue. In order to study human anatomy appropriately, we need to divide it into subdivisions include number 1, regional anatomy. This regional anatomy organizes the body into parts like upper limb, lower limb, trunk, back, thorax, abdomen and pelvic, head and neck, and neuron anatomy. The second subdivision of anatomy is microscopic anatomy. Within this subdivision, we look at the microscopic structure of tissue and organs. The third division of human anatomy is clinical or applied anatomy. On this applied anatomy is a practice of application of anatomical knowledge to the diagnosis and treatment. A fourth one is surface anatomy. This surface anatomy is study of external features of the body, what you can see with your own naked eyes. There is a fifth subdivision of human anatomy which is most crucial, that is systemic anatomy. It evaluates the body of divine defined system. Here, the systemic anatomy may let us recall body system and their function. Do you still remember some systems of human body? Let's see them together. Number 1, it is integumentary system. The integumentary system is made of skin, hair, nails, sweat glands, and other exocrine glands. The second system is musculoskeletal system. The musculoskeletal system enables the body to do movement and take posture. The third system is nervous system. The nervous system collects and processes information from senses via the nerve and the brain, tells the muscles to contract or cause physical action. The fourth one is endocrine system. This endocrine system influences the function of body using hormone. The fifth is circulatory or cardiovascular system. This circulates blood around the body via heart, arteries, and veins. Also, derive oxygen and nutrients to organ and cells and call their waste products away to be eliminated from the body. The sixth system of the human body is digestive system. Digestive system absorbs nutrients and removes waste via gastrointestinal tract. This gastrointestinal tract is made of the organs which include mouth, esophagus, stomach, and intestine. The seventh one is lymphatic system or immunosystem. This lymphatic system defends body against pathogens that may harm the body. The eighth system is respiratory system. It brings air into and out the lungs to absorb oxygen and remove carbon dioxide to be eliminated out. The ninth is renal and urinary system. This is where kidney filter blood to produce urine. The 10th is reproductive system. Reproductive system contains reproductive organs that are required for reproduction and producing the offspring. So, as we mentioned before, the body structure goes with its function. We need to know this structure, what it do. If you are now going to target on the function of such organ, we are going to do physiology. That's why it is important to study physiology in order to know the function of each body part. As the anatomy, also we need to divide physiology into subdivision for easy studies. Here are some subdivisions of physiology. There are about 8 subdivisions of physiology, up to 9. The first one is cell physiology. It studies function of the cell. The second is pathophysiology. It studies the functional change as associated with disease and aging. The third is exercise physiology, which studies on the changes in the cell and organ function during muscular activity. The fourth is neurophysiology. It studies the function characteristics of nerve cells. The fifth is endocrinology. It studies hormones and how they control body function. The sixth is cardiovascular physiology. It studies the function of heart and blood vessels. The seventh is immunology. It studies the defense mechanisms of body. The eighth is respiratory physiology. This respiratory physiology studies the function of air passageway and lungs. The ninth one is renal physiology, which studies the function of kidney. So, I would like you to watch the next video, which will be talking about what each system per system, its organs, how they work, their structure, and their parts. So thank you very much for watching this video. Please press like and subscribe on my channel. Thank you very much.